Hey, what's up YouTube? It's ICU, and today Apple has released iOS 13.5 to the general public, and in this video, I'm not only going to show you how to jailbreak 13.5 on supported devices, but we're also going to talk about the jailbreak status for newer devices. And actually, I did a full-fledged video on the subject. If you happen to miss it recently, I did a deep dive into the current state of jailbreaking. Check it out. It will be linked in your cards now, as well as down below in the description. Again, that's the latest information, and nothing has really changed from then to now. But it will just be a quick recap at the beginning of this video, and then we're gonna get into how to jailbreak 13.5 on older devices. So timestamps can be found down below in the description, so you can skip to whichever section or sections most interest you. But first, I want to preface all of that by saying I really do not recommend updating to iOS 13.5 at all. Reason being is that potentially iOS 13.5 may patch kernel vulnerabilities that could be exploited and rolled into a new jailbreak like Uncover. Now, we have seen this in the past. Most recently, Apple actually closed a key kernel vulnerability in iOS 13.4 that exists in 13.3.1, which itself patches the former Uncover iOS 13.3 jailbreak. But if, for whatever reason, you updated past iOS 13.3, those on 13.3.1 have a better shot of being able to jailbreak than anyone on a higher firmware. However, as I mentioned in my last video covering the state of jailbreaking, for a bunch of reasons we're not going to get into, security researchers and developers are not too keen on spending a lot of time on that specific firmware to exploit and in turn jailbreak it, and instead may wait for something else. For instance, if iOS 13.5 closes key kernel vulnerabilities, then that is the worst possible firmware to be on. As of now, if we visit Apple's security updates page, which basically just contains all security updates for their operating systems and also things like Safari, you can see here that the latest entry is just iOS 13.4.1. As of recording this video, this is a live video, so this is not pre-recorded, and it says this update has no published CVE entries. So we don't have anything yet for iOS 13.5. If and when Apple updates this page, well, not if, they will update this page. And when they do, I will let you guys know if there's anything of interest. I'll be the first to let you know the second we know whether or not iOS 13.5 closes any such key kernel vulnerabilities. And in fact, I actually refreshed that while I was talking and nothing has changed. Again, another refresh. We still have iOS 13.4.1 as the latest entry there. So nothing has changed, nothing's updated yet, but I would be willing to bet, since this is a major point update, that Apple potentially has some security fixes up their sleeve and they might have actually closed some key kernel vulnerabilities. So avoid it at all costs. Obviously, if you have an older device though, you can still update and jailbreak with all of the caveats associated with the checkrain jailbreak, which we're going to get into in just a second. But of course, if you want the potential to be able to jailbreak semi-untethered sans computer, then definitely stay as low as you possibly can. That's the main takeaway I want you guys to come away from this video with at this point. Okay, so with that said, what about the jailbreak status for newer devices? Well, I mean, that's kind of what I was already talking about, right? We haven't really had any new exploits since the release of Uncover for iOS 13.3. That includes and encompasses all devices. That's what we really need. We need a new kernel exploit to then have someone like HackerPwn to own, update his Uncover jailbreak and release a new jailbreak that includes support post iOS 13.3. Now, I went over all of this in the aforementioned state of jailbreaking video, which, like I said, I'll have linked below, and I will also have below this jailbreak status checker page. I highly recommend it if you are currently locked out of the iOS 13.3 Uncover jailbreak. Really, all you have to do is just navigate to this page. You can refresh it regularly. It's dynamic, not static, which means that the second anything changes, this red no will change to a green yes, and download links for the next jailbreak will be listed there, as well as full instructions. Now, this page not only pertains to iOS 13.5, but all the way back to iOS 13.3.1. Really, the second a new jailbreak is released, whatever the target firmware is, whether it's 13.3.1, 13.5, or heck, even iOS 13.4, this page will be updated to reflect that. So this is an all-in-one jailbreak status checker page for the latest firmwares on the latest devices. And obviously, if you have one of those latest devices, you're on iOS 13.3 or lower, definitely just avoid this update, as I already mentioned. So that's everything, guys. That's the current state of things as they stand now. And if you want additional information, as I've been saying throughout this video up until this point, check below in the description. I know it sounds redundant, but I really can't state that enough, guys, simply because I'm going to receive so many questions still asking about the current state of jailbreaking, and I already did a video on that, and everything still applies, so check below. Now, let's get into jailbreaking for A11 and older. Really, all you need is a Mac computer, or you can actually do this with Windows, but you do need a USB flash drive, and you need a little bit more patience and some time, and you need to know how to enter BIOS for your computer. If any of that scares you, definitely check down below in the description, because I will have a link to my Windows jailbreak tutorial. It contains everything you need to be able to jailbreak on Windows. It's super, super simple. The process is very easy. It just takes a little bit of extra work, because essentially what you're going to be doing is getting a Linux distribution up and running on your Windows-based PC that you're going to actually flash to a flash drive. So this is super, super easy stuff. And if you follow this tutorial as well as the corresponding video found below, then you can jailbreak in no time. The steps are identical. Really, the only thing that differs is having to get up until the point where you actually jailbreak with Checkrain. So that's below for Windows users, but we're going to be doing the official version, Checkrain for macOS, because as of now, that's still the latest release. And believe it or not, all of the same caveats still apply. Nothing has changed. And you might be wondering, well, what caveats? Let's get into those now. First and foremost, again, this only supports up to the iPhone 10 with its A11 CPU and older. The iPhone XS, XR, and iPhone 11 series are not supported. So A12 and A13 devices are left out. This also includes, of course, anything newer than the 2018 iPads. So the iPad Pros and up, not included. And it's also tethered, which means that if you want to use your jailbreak stuff, so to speak, anytime you reboot or restart your device or it dies, you have to actually reboot it with the assistance of your computer to enable the use of your jailbreak stuff. But you can still use all stock iOS applications, meaning every single app that came with your device fresh off of the factory floor without having to use a computer. So it's fantastic. If your device accidentally reboots, you're not stuck with a brick. And again, on that subject, you do in fact need a computer for this jailbreak, and it only officially supports macOS, no native Windows support, but again, with the workaround that I just mentioned, you can actually jailbreak with Windows. Check out that video, the same steps apply. Okay, so with all of that said, if you feel comfortable proceeding, definitely navigate to either of the articles, whichever one, whether it's for Windows or for macOS, and you're just going to download the corresponding downloads. So this step will basically be the exact same. So just click on the big download button and you will then be redirected to a page where it's just gathering the links. And once that's done, you're basically just going to click right where it says click here. Couldn't be easier, right? And once you do that, you're going to then be redirected to the download page. Since we are doing the official version, what we're going to do is click on get the beta now, followed by download for macOS. And again, this is where the steps do differ based on which operating system you have, but follow the aforementioned video and you will be completely fine. Okay, so now we're just going to open up our downloads and I'm just going to mount the checkrain.dmg or disk image file. And once it does that, it's going to bring up this little pop-up right here. We can close out of Safari. We no longer need it. We're just going to drag Checkrain over inside of our applications folder. Now, I already have Checkrain in applications. I have an older version, so I'm going to click on replace. If this is the same for you, then again, click replace, and it will just automatically change that out with the latest version of Checkrain. Next, we need to just launch Checkrain from within inside applications, and you'll receive this pop-up here stating that Checkrain cannot be opened because the developer cannot be verified. This is completely fine. Click on cancel. You actually need to receive this pop-up first, so try to open Checkrain. You'll get this pop-up. click on cancel, and then open system preferences on your Mac. Click on security and privacy, and under the main general tab right here, you receive this message here where it says CheckRain was blocked from use because it is not from an identified developer. This is completely fine. This is just a safeguard on Apple's part. There's nothing malicious about CheckRain. Go ahead and click on open anyway, followed by open again to the pop-up. And now one more time, you need to manually open up CheckRain. And here we go. So you can see that CheckRain has successfully identified my iPhone. It says the firmware is not supported. I'm gonna show you guys how to work around that really quick, but I would not be doing my job justice if I didn't at least first let you guys know that it is recommended that you should create an update inside of either Finder if you are on a Mac, or of course, if you are using Windows, at least just for the backup stage, inside of iTunes. This is just a precautionary measure. I've used CheckRain so many times on so many different devices and nothing has gone wrong for me, but it's always better safe than sorry and better to err on the side of caution. So what you do is just navigate to your device section, and I do recommend also checking the option to encrypt local backup. That way it does save things like your health data as well. So you would tick that option, set a password, verify a password, and you can even remember it in your keychain. So that way you don't really physically have to remember this password so long as you have your keychain password. But I do recommend setting this to something that you will in fact remember because you will need it. So let's go ahead and click on cancel. That's just an option there. If you don't care about health data, then you can just proceed and you just click on backup now. That's it. Click on backup now, and if you need it, if in the event that you actually have to restore from a backup, you would just come back to this exact same screen right here and then click on restore backup. So that's just a fail safe. We don't actually need it, but in case we do, it's better to be safe than sorry, like I said. So at this point, you might be saying, well, what the heck? You know, the iPhone is listed, but it doesn't support it. Well, guess what? We can actually tell CheckRain to bypass this, and that's because CheckRain utilizes a boot-ROM-based exploit that simply cannot be patched by Apple. It's a hardware exploit within the silicon of the chips themselves, and this is why this does not work on newer A12 and A13 powered devices. Now, I'm actually just going to unplug my iPhone from this dock right here because we cannot have a dock in the way. This has to be connected directly to USB. There cannot be any third-party docks sitting in between the connection. So let's go ahead and click on options here, and we're going to tell CheckRain again to bypass this by checking off allow untested iOS, iPadOS, tvOS versions, and we're going to click on back and then click on start. Now, based on when you are actually watching this video, you may not have to do that option. CheckRain may just automatically detect that the current firmware your device is on is supported. If that's the case, you can go ahead and just click on start, where you receive this pop-up because we checked off that untested firmware option. We can go ahead and click OK to that, however, and then it's just letting us know that it's going to put our device into recovery mode first before we have to enter DFU mode. So go ahead and click on next, and this is one of the ways that CheckRain actually ensures that it protects the data on your device and that no file system corruption will occur. So let's go ahead and wait for this thing to enter recovery mode. You can see this is the default screen for recovery mode, and now it's just telling us that we're going to enter DFU mode. These are the same steps for the iPhone 10 as well as the iPhone 7 models. If you have an older device, the steps will be listed here, but it's pretty simple based on your device. Again, it could be a combination of holding down the home button as well as the side button, or volume down and side buttons, but it's super simple. It's easier on all other devices. The steps will be listed there. So now at this point, I'm gonna go ahead and click on start. I already know that I need to hold down the side and the volume down buttons together for about 4 seconds before then releasing the side button and continuing to hold volume down. So let's go ahead and click on start. And now the countdown begins, and I'm going to release the side button right here and keep holding volume down. Okay, with that in mind, it should immediately bypass that screen inside of CheckRain, stating that the device has entered DFU mode, and now it's good to go. Make sure your device does not disconnect during this stage, and pretty much just leave it alone. It's going through the process right now, however, and it's actually exploiting the boot ROM. You can see things are moving along swiftly, and we are practically jailbroken at this point. The boot ROM has been exploited, and here we are at the lock screen. Let's go ahead and just swipe up, and I'm gonna enter my password and we'll be right back. All right, so here we are now, and you can see we have the CheckRain application on our device. So we can go ahead and open it up and install Cydia. So just tap on Cydia followed by install Cydia to that little pop-up down there at the bottom, and it's just going to download everything that it needs and put Cydia on your device's home screen. Now, you do need an active internet connection, so if your device is not connected to the internet, then make sure you do, whether it's Wi-Fi or cellular. And you can see that everything worked fine. We have Cydia now, and it is working properly. So we are fully jailbroken, guys. How amazing is that? And you can see here that we do have an essential update pop-up right here. I'm just going to tap on ignore temporary, and I want to show you guys that this iPhone is in fact running the latest firmware, being iOS 13.5 with the latest version of Cydia. So down below at the bottom right here, let's go ahead and unplug. You can see that it confirms this is an iPhone 10.3. That's the identifier for the global iPhone 10 running iOS 13.5 with the latest version of Cydia. Now, at this point, I recommend installing any and all available changes inside of the changes section. So I'm going to tap on upgrade followed by confirm, and you can see Cydia works. Everything just functions as you'd expect. We are now fully jailbroken. So that's basically it for this video, guys. If you want to know what to do from here and which tweaks to get now that you are jailbroken and now that you do have Cydia, then definitely check out some of our top tweaks videos listed down below in the description, and they should also appear shortly after this video. And one absolutely final note here is that, as I mentioned, one of the caveats is that this is a tethered jailbreak. So anytime you reboot, your device restarts, whatever it happens to be, if your device powers off and you power it back up to use your jailbreak stuff, as I've said earlier, you need to boot tethered. To do that, basically just rerun through the CheckRain jailbreak process. It's super easy and only takes a couple of minutes max. So follow this video again if you reboot your device. So I hope you guys liked this one. I hope it helped you out. If it did, be sure to give it a like. And until next time, this is ICU signing out.